So in order for us to use any coding in this course, it really doesn't matter when it's HTML, CSS, JavaScript. You need to have a text editor, and I highly recommend using Visual Studio Code because it really doesn't matter if you're using Windows or Mac, the same thing with Figma. Once you download the software, you can customize all the keyboard shortcuts as well as you can customize the theme. So make sure to search for Visual Studio Code and go ahead and download it. So once you download VS Code, you might get again a page startup like this that it suggests you to open a new folder or create a new file. It really doesn't matter if you get this startup. I'm just going to close this welcome page. And I want to showcase that if you decide to use VS Code, you always have to open a folder to be able to use it. And the way you can check the folder is again on the top left side, you would click on explore. And then here you see we don't have a folder, so you can click on open folder and select your folder, or simply on your basically desktop machine, whether you're using Mac or Windows, you can create your folder. So I'm going to call this design, and then as soon as I have this, I can click and drag it and then just leave it here. And what you notice is now Explore doesn't have that open folder option anymore. If you like to always get this welcome, you can have this as checked, but if you uncheck it, you won't get the welcome anymore. I leave it as is, so I'm going to close the welcome. And now here, if I click on explore, you see now I don't have anything here. It might be confusing, but we are going to walk through how to use VS Code if you're a designer and you have no idea how to use a code editor. But one of the important things that you can think about when it comes to Visual Studio Code is their extension. In Figma, you can call these as plugins. In VS Code, they're called extensions. And you can find it by basically clicking on the extensions here. And then you see we have this two tiny tabs. Again, if you're not able to see this clearly, you can hold command and again plus to zoom in. This will make your Visual Studio Code larger. And I'm going to close this because we no longer need this. We already dragged our empty folder in our Visual Studio Code. And as you can see, I have some popular extensions. I can click on this to collapse this and click on the recommended. And as you can see under install, when I click on it, nothing happens because I have zero extension installed. So for example, if I go ahead and open an HTML file, again, it really doesn't matter. I'm just going to go through it quickly and let's just go ahead and have all the HTML created. We will cover this in depth when we go through HTML. And if I see this, if I go ahead and save this, you see that the HTML tags are highlighted differently. So how do we change the look and feel of our Visual Studio Code? We can select some pre-default themes, and you find these by going basically to File and Preferences on Windows, I think. However, on Mac, you would just click on your code and then Settings. And then here you would be able to have your theme selected, but it would be better if you could search for it because again, you might be using Windows or Mac. So the placement of these icons and settings might be different. So you can always search for it the same way you search for stuff in Figma or any software that you use. The command shortcut for search is different. In VS Code, if you're installing it for the first time, it's going to be Command Shift P. Here you can always take a look at the bottom left of my screen. If I press a shortcut, you would be able to see that. Here you see I hold Shift, Command, and P, and that will open the search results for me. And let's just go ahead and exactly change this shortcut because in Figma we have this mapped to Command forward slash. That will open up the search and you can search for actions in Figma. So let's just go ahead and make sure VS Code also has this shortcut the same way as Figma. So what you can do is search for shortcut, and then here you have two different options, the JSON and the preference version. So we don't want to click on JSON for now. We would like to click on preferences, open keyboard shortcuts. And again, you can always get help. Here you see we have help keyboard shortcut references. If you click on it, it will open up the keyboard shortcut for you. Again, here the command is show command palette. And based on my operating system, since I'm using Mac, it only defaulted to Mac shortcuts. If you're using Windows, it would be defaulted to Windows shortcuts. And again, the first shortcut that you need to learn, and it's a must, again, is Shift, Command, and P. That'll bring up the search. Here in Visual Studio Code is called show commands. So make sure you open this on your end, and let's just go ahead and customize the first one so it actually looks exactly like Figma, so we don't need to memorize two different shortcuts, and this way we have a consistent shortcut to follow. Again, I'm going to hold Command Shift P to bring up the shortcut. Again, you can search for help keyboard shortcut references, but again, what I need to search for is shortcut. And then in this example, I don't want to click on the JSON. I want to click on open keyboard shortcuts preferences. And when I click on it here, I can also collapse this one here. Let me just go ahead and click the explore to collapse this. And we already saw that reference. The search is show command. So there we go. And as you can see here, we have the action here, which is show all command, which is binded to shift, command, and P. And the way you can change it is by clicking on this pen icon. However, on the right-hand side, you can also take a look at this, which is source. That means this is a system default shortcut. And as soon as you make an override to the existing shortcuts that Visual Studio Code offers, this would change to user. So let's just go ahead and click on this pen icon. As soon as you click on the pen icon, it tells you to have your keyboard combination pressed, and then finally press enter. So what I would do is I would hold command and then forward slash. And then here you see it command forward slash appears. And now it tells me that I have three existing commands that has the same bindings. We can take a look at those and then basically remove those from the other ones. But what matters is I do want this show all command to be command forward slash, which is aligned to Figma. And then once I'm happy, I can press return on my keyboard or enter. And now I see that the first one, which is command forward slash, shows all the commands. And now this is changed to user. That means if I basically, let me close everything. If I want to search for something, now you see my show all commands is command forward slash. So here, if I hold command and forward slash, you see on the left hand side, the shortcut shows up. I can have the search results. And previously we were talking about changing the theme. So here we would just basically search for it instead of going down, you know, the file or code. It might be different on different operating systems. We can just simply search for it. And then we could just go ahead and search for the keyword theme. And then here we have preferences again showing up for us. And then what I need to do before actually selecting anything, I'm going to click on explore and then double click on index.html. So this way I'm able to see the HTML code and how it looks like. So here I'm going to hold command forward slash and then search for theme. I already know that Visual Studio Code has built-in themes. Again, you can toggle between light and dark theme, but what we need to select is color theme. And then when I click on it, these are all built-in Visual Studio Code, so I can just use my keyboard. Here you see I am selecting like solarized light, and then I can go up, light again, modern, Visual Studio Code light. And then here the default is Visual Studio Code dark on my system, and you can browse different again themes here. And then based on the theme that you select, your HTML code and also JavaScript code is changed as well. Or simply you can just click outside and then go on the extensions. This way we learn how to install plugins. In VS Code, plugins are referred to as extensions. So here I would just search for material theme. Again, we have multiple ones published, and these extensions are developed by third-party developers, so they can come and go. Sometimes the extension is available, maybe down the line it might not be supported, so you can always choose the extension that is most recent and then has also, you know, a lot of downloads and reviews. And I can show an extension, let me just remove that. There was an extension called SAS Live, and then as you can see, this was a popular extension that compiled SAS code. I used to use this extension, but right now you see Visual Studio Code gives this warning that this extension is deprecated, so make sure not to install this. So you have again other developers building those extensions, and in this example we have this one. So there are alternatives when it comes to extensions, and then if you want to remove this, you can simply click on this one and remove everything that you search for. Here I'm just going to paste the material theme, and then here I can just simply click and drag this to read more about it. And I would go ahead and select the first one, material theme. Here I would click on install. And then once I install the theme, again, it automatically pops up the themes for me. So I have the ability to select the themes. But if it didn't pop up, I can basically click outside and escape this. It really doesn't matter. It already installed it for me. So what I would do is I would click on this one and close this. Here I have my HTML. So what I would do is I would hold command forward slash and then search for color theme. And then I would select the first one. And since I installed this plugin or extension, I can now basically use more themes that are developed by other people, and I can use it in my actual Visual Studio Code. The one that I use, again, it's up to you what kind of themes you want to use, but the one I use is basically material theme high contrast. So I'm happy with this. I can go ahead and select this. And right now you see my HTML syntax highlighting is different. So I can go ahead and select again the extensions. Since we already installed the material theme, I can click again, let me just drag this. It already automatically installed the material theme icons as well. And what you notice is this is developed by the same person. That's why once you install the first one, it automatically installs the second extension for you. And what this does, it actually changes the icons of your files. Here, let me just go ahead and click. And then I'm going to basically create another file. Again, you can just ignore basically the files that I create. But I just want to showcase that here you see we have these type of icons, and then we already installed a theme and it automatically installed the icons. So how do we change the icons in our Visual Studio Code? We would hold command and forward slash and search for the keyword icon. And then here again, we have preferences, file, icon, theme. So what I would do is I would just select this. And now here again, we have some default icons that are added to Visual Studio Code. But right now we can go ahead and actually select different icons because we already installed the theme. And then here you see, as soon as I go over these icons, the left hand side changes. So here, this is again the default Visual Studio Code. If I go ahead and select material theme icon, which is the first one, I have the icons change for me. Again, I'm going to select this. You can also explore other options. Again, if you don't like the themes, you can always go to extensions. Maybe you can install material icon themes by this developer. Here, I'm going to select this and install this so I can show that we have, again, different ways to explore extensions. And let's assume that this didn't show up for you. Again, here it tells you that this is the current, which is material theme icon. We're now installing another one, which is kind of confusing. It's called material icon themes because this developer renamed this to material icon theme. So if I go ahead and select this here, you see my icons are changed now. So I can go and basically hover over the material icon themes, the current one. You see it has changed to this one. Or I can again search for icon, which is again preferences, file, icon, theme. As soon as I select this, now you see again I have all those options, but the new one that I installed is called material icon theme. So I can basically select this and now you see the icons has changed. If I go and select the previous one, it looks like that. And then finally, if I go with Visual Studio Code, it looks like this. So I'll go ahead and select the first one, material-icon-theme, and I'm happy with this. Since I don't use the other icon extension, I can go and select extensions, click on this one, and I can disable the icons here. So here I can uninstall this. It tells me to restart, so I would go ahead and restart. In this example, I only use the themes, not the icons. So if I don't need anything, I can simply uninstall this and go ahead and choose another icon that another developer has built. Again, another important extension to install is called Prettier. If I go ahead and let me just close this and go back to the file explorer, let me select the index.html. Here you see if I, by accident, just try to press return, and if I save this, you see the formatting is ruined. Again, let me just do that and save this, and then let me also just go ahead and do that, save this. Here you see, as soon as I save any changes, the formatting is off. It would be nice if you have an extension that actually auto reformats this for you. So let me just go ahead and close all of these. And the extension that I use to reformat my coding is called Prettier. And then here you can again go to extensions, search. Let me just collapse these. There we go. Search for Prettier. I installed this again by Prettier. So Prettier code formatter, there are multiple versions. Again, you have again some others that are deprecated. So I go ahead and install Prettier by Prettier. Here I would click on install. And then if I go back here and then try to save this, it automatically reformatted everything for me. Let me command Z that. Again, if it didn't happen on your end, you have to enable Prettier by default. So the way you would enable this is, again, let me just collapse this. So again, let's imagine that your formatting is not working. Again, if it's working on the bottom right side of your screen, if I click on this, you see we have the Prettier enabled. Again, don't worry about all of this. I can just simply close this. If your Prettier is not enabled after installing your extension, you could hold command and forward slash and then search for settings. And what you can see is, again, settings, parentheses, UI, or JSON. So what we want to select is the UI version. So here I'm going to click on the UI version. And then what you can see on the left-hand side, we have workspace and users. Here I'm going to collapse everything. And you can see these are all the settings that you have on the left-hand side. And as you can see, you have the ability to change all the settings. So what I want to do is to make Prettier the default formatter when it comes to coding. So here I would just click here and then search for default format. And then here you see, as soon as you search for that, we have all these options that are filtered for us on the left-hand side. Also, the one that we care about is the editor, which is default formatter. Here, since I already installed Prettier, it automatically selected this for me. But let's say that this is none in your example. And then here, I'm going to save this. You see right now, command S, I'm saving this and it's not reformatting for me. So I have to make sure I go to settings and then search for default format. In this example, we have default formatter. And then I would click on this dropdown and then I would select Prettier. And then as soon as I select Prettier, it would set my entire VS Code formatter as Prettier. And then now if I go ahead here and then basically try to make this, you know, a little bit messy. There we go. And then as soon as I hold command and S, It auto formats everything for me. So I'm going to Command Z that, and now I go back to settings. And as you can see, if I scroll down, we have again the formatting for SAS, LESS, CSS, HTML, everything is enabled for us. So what you can do again is always search for the command, which is print width in this example. And then here it filters out everything for me. The default is set to 80. And if I click on this here, you see it formatted my HTML like this. So what Prettier does is it counts the characters from the left-hand side of your screen. If it's less than 80 characters, it leaves it at one line. If it's more than 80 characters, it will wrap it. So for example, I can come to settings and then I can leave this as 40. And then once I'm happy with this, I would come here and then basically add a space. So we have this icon highlighted for us that we made a change here. And then if I save this, you see automatically it wrapped that for me. Usually you can leave the setting as 80 to 90. Here I would go back and I can just, for example, leave this as 90. I always change this setting because sometimes I do want my code to go all the way to the end, but sometimes I do want them to wrap if they are very long. So here on the settings, I change the print width back to 90. I can come back to index.html, command and save that, and it auto formats that back to one line for me.